Aloha guys, this is Scuba Chris. This is the new Okuma Hawaiian Custom Ulua Rod. These are new for 2018. It was previewed at the ICAST show, and these were made specifically for Hawaii for Ulua, which is what we call GTs. Okay, there's two models. The boat 13 feet long, two-piece 50-50 split. The medium heavy is good for 50 to 60 pound test line, whereas the heavy, like this one is meant for 50 to 80 pound test line. The medium heavy rods has a lure rating of 7 to 10 ounces, whereas the heavy one is for 9 to 12 ounces. Now maybe next year they might come out with an extra heavy one. I mean, a while back they did have a extra heavy that was rated for much higher, but we're gonna see how this one goes. If there's a good demand for this, I'm sure Okuma will listen to us and come out with the extra heavy for sliders. Okay, the weight of the medium heavies, they are 29.9, whereas the heavies are 36.1. So that's pretty decent weight. It's very easy to use. They're very, very light. Okay, the rods come with stainless steel rods. Here, hollow rods already epoxied onto the butt. And this one came with a cap. Actually, all of them came with caps, so I'm not sure if you get the cap too. Maybe you do, I'm not sure. But they all come with stainless steel butts. Stainless steel is a lot harder than aluminum. The aluminum butts are gonna scratch a lot. You're gonna see the scratches, and eventually corrosion will set in. But the stainless steel butts is the way to go. And you know, during the advertising, they said you can stick these into the lava rocks. Most people over here, we don't stick these into lava rocks. What we do is we put this on the ground and we put the tip of our foot against this to brace ourselves to haul in the fish. But normally we put them into spikes, either rock spikes for lava fields. If you're on lava fields or if you're on sandy or rocky areas, we use sand spikes. The look is really good. They have this 3K woven material for looks. Looks really sharp. The predecessors to this had abalone inlay, so this is a little different look. You also have shrink wrap tube, okay? This is good, especially when your hands are wet or you got through just handling your bait and your hands are slippery. So it's good to have this shrink wrap tube on your rods. A added bonus that Okuma has put onto the Ulua rods are these brass tubes. Now the brass tubes is for your bell. So when you put your bell in, you can actually hear when there's a strike and when there's a nibble. Now normally if I'm in a crowded area, I don't want anybody to know when I have a hit, I take this off. But if you're in a really deserted area, nobody else around, keep it on. You can tell that there's something out there, just taking a little wax away at the bait, because you may want to check it later. If these stop, so you may not have no bait left. But it's good to have this bell holder on for your bell. Okay, this is a very, very good representation of how this is going to work. You put your rod into your spike. This is a sand spike that aligned with PVC tube. And I have a safety cord on it. Safety cord, I generally will put it to a second spike. Now you notice there next to the spike, there's sand spike, there are rock spikes. Okay, so it depends what you want to use. If you're in a rocky area, sandy area, you can go back and forth between the rock spikes and the sand spikes. So when you're going up, you notice that the bell hangs right there. So if you get a hit, it's gonna let you know when there's something going on. And that's the way it's gonna look in real time application. Another little trick you may wanna employ if you don't wanna lose your expensive rod is on your safety line. If you have nothing to tie it to, always bring a 5 gallon bucket. A 5 gallon bucket is good to sit on. It's also your portable bathroom. And in this case, you can fill it with sand or water and it'll stay right there. Now, if you're in a sandy area and you wanna be a little bit more compact, you can put it down like that and dig it into the sand and it'll work just as well. At the end of the day, when I'm out in the field, I really don't like salt water corrosion getting to my gear, especially my reels and my rods. So I'll just bring a spray bottle with me and I spray everything down while in the field. And this way it gets rid of a lot of that salt by the time you get home.